have not had a lot of conversations about diversity and inclusion and gender bias and all of these sorts of things. So I can only imagine that you're also dealing with all of that. And what's your mindset? Where, as you're going through this, are you make it, is it an issue for you? Are you also in the moment, I would say, kind of saying, I'm not even going to deal with that right now because I gotta follow a course.
It's a combination of both. So the course is there, but there's these obstacles and they're everywhere you look. Every single day, I'm reminded that there's no one in my dealership that looks like me, that I'm the only woman at the table. And it's a table that the first time I was brought into, but ever since then, I had to force myself to get there, to sit there, to speak up, to talk about things that I had no idea about, because I wanted them to know that I'm in the room. My voice matters. My thoughts matter. I'll never forget. I had won a contest to Budapest with Audi as one of the top sales performers. And I'm sitting in Budapest. I've never been first class before, right? I'm sitting first class. I get off this plane. They got my name on this little card, Erikka, you know, they get you in a nice limo. And I get to this award ceremony where they're recognizing the top 10 sales managers in the Southeast region. And I'm sitting there in Europe going, this is amazing. And I see all white men. And I'm like, wow, you know, how did I get to this place? And this guy comes up and he says, hey, where's your husband? And I'm like, excuse me? He's like, where's your husband, the one who won the award? And I said, no, it's me. I have the badge. Do you not see it? And I said, even in this moment when I could reach the top of one of my career epitomes, I'm here in this foreign country in Europe among the elite of the Audi sales managers. And even in that moment, I was seen as maybe somebody's wife that came along to join the trip.
Wow.
And I said, you know what? I have work to do because I have to make seeing women like me in this position, in these opportunities, winning these awards seem normal, seem okay, seem regular. And until then, WOCAN will exist because, right, we have to take the opportunity to do deliberate diversity, you know, intentional inclusion, because people say, I want to change the industry, but everybody has the same mindset, right? We hire people that look like us. We hire people that remind us of us because that's what we're comfortable with. And that's our circle, which is fine. Mm-hmm. But then how do you change the very thread of something when everybody who's thinking about it and talking about it are all the same? It's mm-hmm. only until you bring in a different pattern, someone who has been on the edge of resourcefulness, right? Someone who sees life differently because I've had to, because I didn't have a choice, because I knew what it was like to have my lights turned off, to have my rent not being paid, to trying to figure out, you know, can I get a roommate just to make sure I have a roof over my head? I understand what that looks like. And because I never want to be there again, then every decision that I make is one step out of that hole, is one more step to the next level and to the next level. I was telling my salespeople this story about Stone Soup, right? Because I said, hey, we're in the middle of a pandemic. And here we are where everybody's thinking of lack. I don't have, and we don't have inventory. We don't have cars. We have nothing. I said, and the story of Stone Soup is about a guy who takes a stone and he goes into this village and he goes and he knocks on someone's door and he says, hey, I want to make some soup. And they said, no, you know, we have nothing. He's like, well, I see you have carrots out here in your yard. Those are my carrots. You can't have none. So he goes to the next door and they have potatoes. And he's like, hey, you have potatoes. Let's make some soup. And they're like, no, these are my potatoes. We're in the middle of a famine, you know, get out of my lawn. And so everywhere he goes, everybody just kept telling him no. So he finally knocks on a door and he says, I have stone. She says, get away. I'm not giving you anything. He says, I just want to make stone soup. All I need is a bowl. Just give me a bowl. So she goes in, she gets him a bowl and they make a pot and she puts the hot water in and he starts to say, can I just have some spices? I don't want anything else from you. I just want some spices. So he starts to put the salt and the pepper and the basil in there and it's just a stone and water and it starts to smell good. And he says, you know what would make this a little bit better? Is some vegetables. Do you have any vegetables around? She's like, well, yeah, I got some corn. So she puts the corn in and it's just water and a stone and corn. And then next thing you know, other people start knocking saying, we smell something good in the neighborhood. What is that smell? And he says, well, hey, bring your carrots and bring your potatoes. And next thing you know, the entire village is bringing their resources, right? The lack that they only had one of because no one wanted to share. And they're bringing it into this pot and we're mixing it all together. And now we have a soup. Now we have something that's hearty. Now we have something that can feed the entire village. Now we have something that's going to make people healthy. But in the beginning, we had nothing because we were too selfish and self-centered, because we were holding on what we had, because we were greedy and desperate and we couldn't see the bigger vision. And we took nothing, literally a stone, a rock, and created something out of it that could feed everyone. But it took an idea, and it took faith, and it took a vision, and that's what we need more of. People with vision who can understand that in hard times, you get the best out of people.
I'm Michael Cirillo, and you've been listening to the Dealer Playbook Podcast. If you haven't yet, please click the subscribe button wherever you're listening right now. Leave a rating or review and share it with a colleague. Thanks for listening.